Same place, same problems, only a decade apart. In 2013, detainees rioted at Banksia Hill, and the then Shadow Minister had plenty of ideas.
They've been in charge for 5 years. If there is a mess in the prisons, if there's a mess in the Corrective Services Department, they created it.
After 8 years on the portfolio in opposition, advocacy groups were disappointed Paul Papalia didn't keep corrections when Labor took government.
He was very much consultative, very much engaging with the sector, both the community sector as well as the Aboriginal leadership around justice issues.
Well, I think Bill Johnston would love the fact that he's lost Corrective Services. I suspect he wasn't enjoying it, and it was certainly not a good outcome for the state. Let's hope that Paul Papalia might just manage to do a better job.
Treasury, the other major shift, landing with Rita Saffioti.
Rita's an economist and a former Treasury official, and having worked closely with her through our budget committee process over the last 6 years, I know our budget will be in safe hands.
But the opposition points to Metronet blowouts, with Ms Saffioti keeping transport and picking up tourism.
Rita Saffioti absolutely has got too much on her plate.
But the minister is also offloading portfolios, with planning to go to the housing minister, while new minister David Michael picks up local government from John Kerry and takes ports off Rita Saffioti's hands.
I'm very confident, extremely confident, to be able to manage it all.
We're told that this cabinet has the right balance of junior and senior members, but the Labor government has a massive backbench, and a number of those MPs will also be itching for their own spot on cabinet. And it's now up to Roger Cook to keep them happy and in line. James Carmody, ABC News.